Hello all, today we are going to see the next option related to the Sketcher. Last time we have seen whenever we are going to open the UG software, you will find this interface, that is GUI, graphical user interface is there. So I told last time this is called as what, quick access toolbar. This is, we can switch the window. Here more than one windows are open, here it is going to display. Then there is a what menu bar, file, home, tools, like this. There are the three options are there. So last time I told how to enter into the Sketcher workbench. This is called as menu bar and this is a standard toolbar. So whenever we are going to open the part for the first time, we are going to open with the help of new option. Here there is an option called as a new, that is Ctrl plus N is the shortcut for opening the new file is there. So Ctrl plus N is the shortcut for opening the new file. So we can click on new. Once you click on new, we are going to set what? We are going to set the unit first, in which unit you are going to work inside this one. Then if I want to go inside Sketcher, here there is an option called as model. Can you see? We have to select here as model. There are different workbench for entering into the different things. So we have to select model when we are going to open inside the Sketcher workbench. And here we are going to give the name for that part. Whatever name you want to give it, that name we can give. Again here I told .prt is the extension of the Sketcher file. This Sketcher file extension will have .prt, .prt as the extension. And I told here we are going to set what, the folder in which you are going to save your work related to what, the UG is there. You are going to save your work related to what, the UG is there inside that one. So after making that as a folder unit, and then we are going to switch to the OK. If you already made some folder, we can assign it directly by taking this as a reference is there. Directly we can select here as OK is there. So once you select the unit, first unit, then the model, and then the Sketcher name, and then we are going to assign the folder in which you are going to save your work. After making all this, you have to click OK. So once you click on OK, it is going to enter into what, the Sketcher workbench. It is going to enter into what, the Sketcher workbench is there. It is going to enter into the workbench called a Sketcher workbench. So what I told, first of all, what we are going to do, we are going to create the three planes. Here from here we can select three plane. Datum plane, I told last time, the tree which shows the history of command, it is called as part navigator. Inside UG, the history which shows list of all the commands is called as what, part navigator. And here we are going to take the datum plane is there. Here from here we can take what, the datum plane is there. So we can click on datum plane over here. Once you click on datum plane, it will ask on which plane you are going to create. So what are the datum planes we are going to take? We are going to take XCYC, applied, first plane. Then I am going to take the plane as YZ, applied, and then the third plane I am going to take it as XZ and applied. So like these three planes we have taken, XCYC, YCZC and XCZC. Once you select all the plane, you have to click on cancel. So we have to press cancel, because if you click OK, the last plane will get repeated over the whatever plane you have selected at last. Same plane will get repeated twice. So this is the interface of the what, the Sketcher or the modeling part. Now there are three planes. I will told the mouse shortcut, scroll up and down is a shortcut for zoom in zoom out, only middle scroll button is the shortcut for rotate, and if you press shift and middle scroll button, it is a shortcut for pan. I have got these options all. Mouse shortcuts are what, zoom in zoom out is scroll up and down, only middle mouse button is for rotate, and one more is pan. You have to press shift and you have to press middle scroll button. So these were the mouse shortcut. If you want to do that inside this one, so here there are option, this is the rotate, F7 if you type, it is going to execute the rotate option. Can you see? And again if you type F6, it is a shortcut for zoom in zoom out. We can select the area, whatever area you want to make it zoom in zoom out, like that it is there. So if the screen is not exactly in the middle, then what I told, you have to fit. Here there is also pan. Pan means movement, I told inside this one. It is a pan is there. So fit to screen is here, Ctrl plus F. If your screen goes beyond this one, you have to bring it inside middle one. Ctrl plus F is a shortcut for fit. So like these were the options what we have covered in the last session. So I told in order to enter into the sketcher, what we are going to do, we are going to specify the path, that is menu, insert, then sketching task environment. Can you see the option menu insert sketching task environment is there? If you click on menu insert sketching task environment, once you click the sketching task environment, you select the plane on what plane you are going to create the sketch, and we have to click here OK. So as soon as you make the plane as done, then what we have to do, we have to execute the some option related to the sketcher. Last time we have covered the option like profile, line, rectangle, arc and circle. Before covering that option, I told one important setting that we have to make what the continuous auto dimensioning should be off. So from where it has to be done, here if you select here display sketch constraint, there is a arrow below that. So click once and here you have to make it as what continuous auto dimensioning. We have to make what the continuous auto dimensioning is off. We are going to make it as what continuous auto dimensioning is off. Once you do that, then we are going to start with the sketcher. So as soon as you make that option off, last time we have started with the pattern curve. So once again I explain the pattern curve. Suppose I am going to draw a simple rectangle over here, suppose like this rectangle. Then after drawing this rectangle, I am going to make what constrain it. So I told at the time of seeing all this command how to constrain the different geometries. So right, like now there is a rectangle, right? So I need see here the status bar, it is showing that it requires 4 constraint. So if I want to give any type of dimension, there are 2 types of constraint as we have studied earlier, that is geometric constraint and dimensional constraint. So in order to give the dimension for this simple rectangle, in order to give a particular dimension, I'm going to press what D. D is the shortcut for giving any type of dimension. So I'm going to use the option as what rapid dimension, that is a shortcut. And how to take this option from the above tab, here there is an option, that is the rapid dimension is there. Here there is an option as what rapid dimension is there. So here we can specify the option is rapid dimension. So you click on rapid dimension, then you specify the length, you can specify the length is here. Then we have to specify the width, here we can specify. Then we have to specify the origin point, here we can specify the origin point. As soon as you are giving the dimension, the number of constraints should go on reducing. Can you see? Previously it was showing it as 4. As soon as I give this dimension and this dimension, it has converted into 1. So what is the 1 more dimension? Like how I have given vertical dimension, I need to specify the horizontal dimension too, in order to make the sketches fully constrained. So once the sketch get fully constrained, the status bar will show that it is fully constrained, as well as the color of the sketch will turn as what faint green. Can you see the color of the sketch? When it shows if it is a fully constrained, then it is going to get appear as a faint green. This is the color of the sketch as a faint green is there inside this one. So we have given the required dimension in order to make the sketch as what the fully constrained is there. So we can click on close. Like this we have made what the sketch as fully constrained is there. So once you make the sketch as fully constrained, then we are going to make pattern. Pattern means what? If you want to repeat the same feature along number of rows, number of column, we are going to execute the option called as pattern curve. So here there is an option, pattern curve is there. So how to execute this option pattern curve, click on that. Once you click on that, first thing what we are going to select inside curve to pattern is the which curve we have to make it as a pattern, that is select curve. So select curve is what this curve, select this one. So as soon as you select the single line, the whole geometry will get selected, because here the option is what curve rule connected curves. So whatever lines are connected to this line, automatically the entire geometry will get selected. Then we have to go to, after selecting the curves to pattern, then we have to go to what pattern layout. There is a pattern definition, layout is there. So here we have to select all the linear. So once again, if you select the linear, you have to select the reference as object. So select reference as object as axis. As soon as you select the axis, what you do, you first uncheck this as a this one as a direction 2, and here you reduce the pitch. Here we are going to reduce the pitch. Suppose I'm going to give the reduce the pitch as 30. Whatever dimension you are going to give, it is going to create in that direction. Can you see it has created inside this direction? So this is the direction one is there, pitch distance. Can you see this pitch distance? Here we can specify the pitch distance is there. Directly it is going to specify here. So it has created only along this direction, and how much number of count it has been created. Here you have specified number of count as 5. So suppose if I specify 6, so the number of columns will go on increasing. But if you want to specify the number of instances along this direction 2, I have specified the direction 1 as horizontal. If I want to specify the linear direction as vertical, so we have to use the option as what? Use direction 2 is there. So here we can specify use direction 2. Then here we have to specify what? Linear object. Linear object we are going to specify as this axis also we can specify. As soon as you specify, it is going to create the instances along this direction. Only the thing is what? We are going to give the pitch distance. Suppose I am going to give the distance as 30. Whatever distance you will give, that will be the pitch value is there. Can you see? It has generated the number of rows and column. Here we are defining number of rows. Suppose I want 5. These are the number of rows, and the number of count here we can specify as this also 5. So these are the instances whatever we will get. So I told the meaning of these all options in the last session. Count and pitch means distance between this center to this center, that is a pitch. And number of count means this is number of columns what we are defining. If you talk about count and span, this count and span stands for distance between first and last. So whatever distance you are going to give, it is going to specify that as a span distance, that is distance between first and last. And depending upon the number of count, whatever number of count you will specify, that much the pitch will get it adjusted itself. That is distance between first and last, and we are giving the number of count, so pitch will automatically get adjusted. And what is the third option? Pitch and span. Automatically here, whatever pitch distance you are giving, suppose I am going to give the pitch distance as 50, so number of count will automatically get adjusted. That means whatever parameter you are giving, it is going to be the parameter related to first and last is there. Directly we can specify that one. That is the span distance means distance between first and last is there. So like this we can create the pattern inside this layout is there, inside this one, with the help of this option whatever is there. Suppose pitch distance I want 30, so it is going to specify this pitch distance as this one, and number of count it has specified as this one. So like this we are going to specify number of count. Same options are there inside what? Count and span also. Here also we can give the span distance, whatever span distance we want to specify, that is distance between first and last. And the third option is pitch and span, that is span distance means distance between first and last. And what is the pitch distance? Pitch distance means distance between each, whatever pitch distance you are going to specify over that point. So once you make this all, you get to click here OK. So as soon as you click OK, so it is going to create the pattern in that particular direction with reference to whatever count and whatever pitch you have specified. So can you see here the status? Here it is displaying as sketch is fully constrained. That means if your original base is constrained, that is the curve which you are going to make it as pattern, if it is constrained, the remaining on instance also will get automatically constrained itself. That is the meaning of sketch is fully constrained. Can you see here it is displaying sketch is fully constrained? That means the remaining rectangles whatever we have got, that also will get fully constrained. But when this option, when this object, that is a square shape, is a fully constrained is there. It's because if you make this square as fully constrained, then only whatever pattern you are going to do, this all will get as a fully constrained is there. So this is the meaning of what? The pattern inside pattern curve, there is option called as layout as linear. So don't delete this symbol. This symbol stands for the pattern symbol is there. Don't delete this. So if you double click on this, if you double click it, we can again modify the pattern related things, whatever pattern related things is there directly. Count and pitch and span, whatever spacing is there directly we are going to specify over here. Okay. And here we can reverse the direction, if you see, that is upward direction or below direction, this one is there, and this is the right side or left side. Here we can reverse the direction too, depending upon the direction what you are going to give. Here we can reverse the direction, whatever direction is there, above or below, and the right side or left side. Here we can specify. So this is the option called as rectangular pattern. So if you talk about the second type of pattern, there is a option called as circular pattern. Circular pattern means what? Suppose I will draw one here, circular shape. Suppose I'm going to create one circular shape. You click on circle. I told circle's definition is how, means shortcut O. If you type O as the symbol, it is the shortcut for executing the circle command is there. So here we are going to specify circle. We have to type here as what? O. Then we are going to specify as what? The circle. Can you see here? Circle is there. Here we are going to specify center point. We have to specify what as a center point is there. And then we are going to specify this as center point. Then we have to specify the point on circle. It is point of circumference. So as soon as you create any circle, then what we are specifying, can you see it is showing that it requires one constraint. That is, circle require one constraint because origin I have made it coincide with the center of circle. That means its origin is now locked. Only the constraint what I need to give to this circle, it is the radius or the diameter is there. So if I want to give the radius or the diameter for this circle, I will go with the rapid dimension. For example, if you want to give specific radial as the dimension, if you want to give specific radial as the dimension is there. So here we can specify radial dimension also. Here we give diameter. If you want to give specific as the radial dimension, we can use the option as the radial dimension here. We can click here and we have to select the object reference. So here we are going to specify this as a reference. As soon as you give any radius or diameter, here its circle sketch will automatically get constraint is there. Circle figure will automatically get constraint is there. And here we are able to give what? The radius value is there. Radius of that circle is there. So what I am going to do, I am going to create one circle here, somewhere here. And I am going to make it as what? The pattern layout as circular. So if I want to do the pattern layout as circular, I have drawn the circle shape. Now I'm going to create one circle here and I'm going to specify, suppose here is there circle. Here we can specify like this circle we have drawn. So now if you specify the sketch, now if you see at the status bar, it is showing that it requires two constraints. So it requires here what? Two constraints is there. Sketch needs two constraints. So first thing, everybody knows that what constraint we have to apply, that is the dimension to that circle. So I need to specify, suppose if you want to specify radius only, so we can use the option as radial dimension. You specify this circle and you place it. So this is the one constraint we require. So the second thing is what? The position of the center of the circle is not fixed with respect to origin. So if I want to make it fixed, I have to draw one line axis. I have to specify the angle. Otherwise, what we can do, we can make this point to be along any one of the axis, either x axis or y axis. That also will do in order to make the sketch as what? Fully constrained is there. So if I want to make this smaller circle as fully constrained, what I should do, I need to make this point along this axis, that is the x axis is there. I need to make the circle's center point to be aligned with this horizontal x axis is there. So if I want to make this circle center aligned with this horizontal axis, we have seen that there is a geometrical constraint. We can press C and enter. If you type press C and enter, here there is an option called as what? Point on curve. Here there is a constraint called as point on curve. I told meaning of this point on curve, we require two input as point and curve. So I have the point what? Circle center point, and I have the curve, that is x axis. I need to specify that the point should be along what? This axis, that is the horizontal axis is there. So I am going to specify as what? Point on curve. How to execute this constraint? We can click on point on curve, make this option as on automatic selection progression, and use the constraint as what? Point on curve, which is the second constraint inside geometric constraint, which is the second constraint inside geometrical constraint, that is point on curve is there. So you specify the point as this and the axis as this one. So as soon as you make that one as point on curve, your sketch will automatically get fully constrained because we have specified the center of smaller circle to be on the this axis, horizontal axis. As soon as you make that, your sketch will get automatically fully constrained. So I have applied what? Point on curve. Once again, you see, I will make undo with the control Z. I need to make this center to be along this axis. I need to specify this point of circle, that is center point, should be along this axis. So I'm going to use what? Geometrical constraint. So I can type C. I told earlier, if you want to execute the geometrical constraint, we have to type C. In that, there is a constraint called as what? Point on curve. So you specify this point on curve and you select the object to constraint as this one. As soon as you make that, the circle will get automatically along that axis, and as soon as you do that, your sketch will automatically turns fully constrained is there. So what I want to create the circle to be along multiple along this path. I want to create the circle multiple along this path. So in order to do the circle multiple along the PCD path, I have to use the option called as what? Pattern only. But inside pattern, the layout should be what? Circular. The pattern layout should be what? Circular is there. So we can specify pattern curve. We have to specify the option as what? Circular, because I want to follow what? Circular path. Here we can specify circular path is there. So here you have to select what? Circular, select curve to pattern. Here it is there. So select curve to pattern as what? This circle. And then we have to specify what? Rotation point. What is the rotation point we are going to specify? That is the center point. So I'm going to specify the center point as this one, origin. Origin point I am going to specify it. So here again the options will come, that is count and pitch. Count means number of circles, how many you want, and pitch means this is pitch angle. It is not pitch distance. We are going to make the option as what? Pattern curve. Inside pattern curve, we are specifying the pitch angle is there, and if you click on here, apply it, so it is going to create that as a constraint, that is the count and pitch is there. So once you make this as count and pitch, can you see the sketch has become fully constrained and you have got the multiple circles along that what? PCD. So like this we have executed what? The circular pattern is there. Again, if you want to modify it, I told don't delete this symbol. This symbol stands for which type of pattern we have made, that is the circular pattern constraint is there. We have specified the circular path as the option, and we have specified the circular pattern is there. So if you want to modify this pattern now, whatever pattern you have created, I want to modify this as a circle. So double click on that. Once you double click on that, then we can increase or decrease the count. If you increase or decrease the count, and we can able to give what? The pitch distance, that is pitch angle. Whatever pitch angle means, angle between each one. So if you specify the option as count and span, this is a span angle between first and last. If you drag it, so number of instances will automatically get adjusted depending upon this span distance. Span distance means it is the angle between first and last. Whatever span distance you will give, and depending upon the count, it will take the angle between each, that is the pitch angle is there. It is going to get the pitch angle is there depending upon the what you are going to specify. It is going to specify the pitch angle itself. And the last option is pitch and span. Here we are not able to give the number of count because it depends upon the span distance, whatever span distance you will specify, and the angle between each. Angle between the each instances, whatever angle is there, that it is going to take the number of count. It is going to take the number of count as per the pitch and span. So what I told, in any of the these three sub options, any two dimension you have to specify. For example, count and pitch if specify, the total span angle will get automatically adjusted is there. Here we are going to specify the pitch angle means angle between each, and here we are going to specify as what? Number of count. Whatever number of count you are going to specify, that is the actual number of count and the angle between the each instances. Whatever angle is there, that is the angle between each, that is the pitch angle is there. That is what? The pitch angle. So once you make this as count and pitch, then if you click OK, then it is going to show the execute the option as what? Circular pattern. Inside pattern curve, we have made this is what? With the sub option as what? Layout as circular one. So this was the thing related to the circular pattern. I have drawn one PCD circle, I have drawn one circle anywhere, I have made it constrained, then I have made it multiple with the help of option called as what? Circular pattern is there. I have made with the option as called as a circular pattern is there. So these were the two options inside the pattern, that is layout, that is linear pattern, and the circular pattern is there. If you want to execute, there is one more option inside the pattern curve, that is the one more constraint, means one more pattern inside layout. It is a general pattern. General pattern means what? Suppose I am going to specify this as a rectangle. I have drawn here as a one profile as what? Rectangle. We have drawn one profile as a rectangle. I want to copy this rectangle with respect to any point to some other location. This rectangle should get copied as per my point location is there. So in order to copy the rectangle at some other location, we are going to use the option as what? The pattern. That is, the pattern option is called as what? The rectangular pattern is there. Here we have seen rectangular pattern, we have seen circular pattern. If you want to copy this object at some specific point location, then we are going to execute as what? The pattern as what? The third one pattern is there, that is called as the general pattern. So how to execute that option? We can specify pattern curve. Once you click on pattern curve, we have to specify the option as what? General, linear, circular, and the third one is what now? General pattern is there. Here we are going to specify. Again, here we are going to specify what is the first thing we select, that is, it will come under modify, na? So we are going to select the curve to pattern. We are going to select the curve as this. As soon as you select the curve to pattern, then we are going to use the which option? General pattern. Then we are going to specify the point, from what point we are going to copy it. So here is the pattern curve. So you specify the point, and then to, from what point you have to copy, and to what point. From means which base point, to means where we want to keep it. Like this we are going to specify. Can you see? Here we are going to specify the point as this location. Here it is there. So this is a simple type of pattern called as what? General pattern. So general pattern means what? If we want to copy some feature at some specific point with respect to some base point, then we are going to use the option as what? General pattern. So how to execute again this? Just again one, you see how to execute the general pattern. You have to go to option called as pattern curve. You have to select the pattern curve. Then you have to select curve to pattern. I am going to select the curve to pattern as this. Then inside layout, I have to specify the general pattern. Here inside it is there. Here we are going to specify general pattern is there. Specify the radius as before. Suppose I am going to specify the radius as suppose I am going to specify as this one. Radius, if you want to specify as the radius is there. If you want to apply the fillet radius, what we can do? We can apply the fillet option. F is the shortcut. If you type F, it is going to execute the fillet. We can type distance radius, and we can select this one. It is very large. If you specify one as the radius, it has applied 10. So if you want to apply the fillet, what we can do? We can make this as radius first, and we can directly drag also. If you drag it also, it is going to specify, or else we can click simple select. Directly it is going to make it as a fillet is there. And the options are what? Trim and untrim. This is trim and untrim. I told the dotted portion, whatever it is saying, it is the trim mode, and whatever extra lines we are able to see, that is the untrim mode. Like this it is there. So this was the option called as a trim. If you click on this, again there are some options inside fillet. If you type F, if you take here there is option called as create alternate fillet. So for example, if I take trim, I'm going to specify this as a entities to trim. So here it is selecting the fillet as exactly tangent to two entity what we have selected. If you want to create it in opposite direction, the fillet to be created, we can use the option as alternate fillet. Alternate fillet means the opposite portion of the circle which you want to apply the fillet, that fillet we have taken here. Can you see alternate fillet means what? If you click here, by default the fillet output is like this. But in some cases, if you need the fillet to be created in opposite direction, in other direction, the fillet to be created, what we can do, we can use the option as alternate fillet. This is the output for making that as an alternate fillet, means opposite portion. Automatic tangent it is going to create with the same as usual fillet, but if you want to create some other portion to be created, we can use alternate fillet, like this fillet is going to get created. So this is the meaning called as what, fillet. Again, if you see fillet, if you type F, there is an option called as delete third curve. So what is the meaning of this option, that is delete third curve? Suppose I am going to specify these two lines to fillet, and if I want to specify this as an alternate, suppose like this, here if I am going to specify, and if I am going to specify tangent to this line, I am going to specify, it has deleted the three line and it has created tangent to two lines what you have selected. That is the meaning of delete third curve. Means I have selected the entities between these two, there was a line connecting these two line. I have deleted this line with the help of option called as what, delete third curve. Here there is an option called as what, delete third curve as the option. So we can specify these two line and we can make alternate fillet here. So whatever tangent if you want, suppose I want tangent to here only, so I'm going to click here, so whatever the third line you select, it has got to get trim. That is the meaning of delete third curve. Okay, and if you want the line to be remain as it is, uncheck this delete third curve. I will specify the entity as this, again I will specify this one as the other direction, and I'm going to specify the radius as this one. So click here, so it is going to keep this line. That is the meaning of what, delete third curve is there. So these were the options related to the fillet is there. So and the input what we are going to give, we are going to give the radius. If you want to create the chamfer, if I want to create the chamfer, I will use the option called as chamfer, and here we have to select the line. So here there are modes, symmetric. Symmetric means two distance will be same. Here it is going to specify, this is a symmetry, here it is there. Then trim input curve means what, it is going to trim the extra portion whatever it is there, like in fillet it was doing. So if I want to give chamfer with some other parameter, so I am going to specify asymmetric. Asymmetric means I am able to give variable distance on both the direction, suppose 1 and 3. So you specify this and this line and specify this one, so it has created uneven chamfer is there, slant line it is going to create. Again, if you specify distance and angle, we can specify offset and angle. If you want to create standard chamfer, we can use the angle as 45, and here we are going to specify the one as a distance. So here we can specify as the this one, chamfer offset angle, means distance as well as the angle is there. So here also we can drag the thing. If you drag also, it is going to execute, or simple select is there. And here it is, trim input curve means the input curve we are going to trim it or we are going to keep it. And these are the three modes, symmetric, asymmetric, offset and angle. Symmetric means both equal chamfer, both side chamfer will be created equally. Asymmetric means both side uneven chamfer we are going to create. And offset and angle means we are going to give what, the distance as well as the angle is there. Have you got these options related to chamfer? Just you see once again, like fillet, it was creating tangent arc. Here it is creating what? The lines are there. Here directly we can specify. You select this one, drag it. If you want to change it asymmetric, we can give both the side as different distance. Here we can specify distance, we can specify, and we can select the line as this one. And this extra portion, if you want or don't want, we can use the option as what, trim input curve is there. So this was related to the chamfer is there. Then after chamfer, there is an option called as what, make corner. If you have the two lines, suppose this line and this line, if you want the make corner, means if you want the point to be up to a point of intersection should be there. I have drawn two intersecting line, I want the above portion of the line only up to point of intersection is there. So I'm going to use the option as what, make corner. So if I'm going to specify this line and this line, automatically both the line will remain as it is, and the remaining portion which was there after intersection, it has trimmed that. That is the option called as what, make corner. If you want to apply make corner, you specify this as an option, then it will ask which object you have to make it as a corner. Suppose I want to keep it left side of the line, so I am going to specify this side and this side. as soon as you specify this side, both the side, the other portion of the line will get deleted with the help of make corner. That is the option called as the make corner is there. So all the options whatever we are going to see today, they are will come under modify. I told there are two toolbar, one is draw, second one is modify. Pattern, offset, quick trim, quick extend, fillet, chamfer, mirror, make corner will come under what? Modify toolbar. Modify means we need to first select and then we have to execute it. So this was the option related to what? The make corner option. If you want to perform the scaling, if you want to perform the scaling operation, then we can use the option called as move curve. If you apply the option as a move curve means if you want to translate the entity, we have to select again what curve. Suppose this is a curve. Again, this will come under what? Modify, because we are going to select it. Move option will come under modify because we need to select some profile. Then distance vector along this direction. I will specify this as this direction. Okay. And angle also we are going to specify. Here we can specify the distance, whatever distance is there. Here we can specify, we can reverse the direction, whichever direction you want. And here we can specify the inferred, whichever vector you want, we can specify that one. Along that direction, the object will get moved. Once again, you see, I want to move this entity from this location to some other location. So I'm going to use the option move curve, which is there where below this move corner, if you click on arrow, there is an option called as move curve is there. Like move, we have seen AutoCAD, we require to give the base point and we require to give the object to move. Whatever curve we have to move it, we can select the curve to move. So this is the curve to move is this one. Then we have to specify the vector. Along what vector we are going to specify? This vector is there. Here we can specify. Inferred we have to do. And we have to select the vector. As soon as you select that as vector, you can drag along that one at specific distance. And we can give what? Angle also. We can specify some specific angle. At what angle that geometry should be rotated. So I will specify 45 degree. Or 0 degree if you specify, it is going to create translate only along that direction. And if you specify the angle as 20, it will get rotated also. With the help of this move curve, we are able to apply two options related to modify, that is move as well as rotate. So I have used the option called as move curve. You click on this, you specify this one, then you have to specify vector. Vector along which, suppose I want vertical, we can specify here as inferred curve and you specify this as this vector. So along this direction the geometry will get translate. Can you see the vector along which what you have specified, it get translated, and along with that we are able to give what the rotation angle. We can give the rotation angle too. So with the help of move curve, we are going to apply the two options related to modify, that is move and applying rotate option. In the same way, if you want to apply scaling of this, if you want to apply the scaling, so I will use the option as what? Scale curve. Here it is option. Scale curve is there. If I want to apply the scaling related option, scale means everybody knows we have to make it enlarge or we have to make it reduce. You select the object, then we can specify the arrow. Arrow wise, it is going to reduce or it is going to enlarge a thing. Here we can specify whatever radius means value you are going to specify, it is going to define here. What scale factor you need to apply? Scale factor means what, depending upon what ratio you are going to get reduced or you are going to get enlarged. Everybody knows that whenever we are going to give less than one as scale factor, it will get reduced, and if I am going to get more than one, it will get enlarged. For example, if I am giving 0.5, it is getting reduced, and if I am giving more than one, it is getting increased. Like this it is there. So if you click OK, it has been scaled. Once again you use a scale option where it is inside this arrow. There is an arrow below move curve. There is an option scale curve. So we have to apply what? Scale curve. We have to select the object as scale, and here we can specify the point with respect to what it should get scale with the help of inferred. Inferred means whatever point you are going to select, that it is going to treat it as a what? The base point or the point with respect to which it is going to perform the scaling. So I'm going to specify the scaling with respect to this point. So this point will be now base point, and it is going to scale with respect to that one. Whatever motion point also we need to specify. Motion point, suppose this one. Here it is going to specify, and then we can able to specify the scale factor, whatever scale factor you want to specify. This is a base point, and this motion point we have specified as this one. So along this it is going to get scaled depending upon your scale factor is there. So like this we can apply scale factor and move curve. So if you want to just only you need to get translate, then we are going to use the option as what? Offset move curve. Offset move curve means what? It is going to only translate. Like in move curve we have selected the option as what? Move curve, if you select, we are able to make what? The translation as well as the rotation. And if you want to only apply the move curve, that is the translation, we can use the option as select curve to move, offset move curve. So here we can specify, here it is the object, and then we are going to make it as distance, suppose 10. Here we can specify, here we can specify distance as 2. Can you see it has getting offset? It is creating offset in one direction and two direction. If you click OK, it has created offset. Offset means it is going to create only in one direction or two direction, means it is going to make it as offset. Like offset command in this AutoCAD, we are going to first select the object, and then we are going to give the distance by which it has to create as what? Offset is there. So we have to select option as what? Offset move curve. Here we have to select curve. So this is the curve. Then can you see this arrow? This arrow is for offset inside or outside. Here we can specify. It is going to apply the offset for the original one depending upon the distance what you specify. Whether you want to create offset inside, here we can specify the direction inside and outside is there. Directly we can specify this one, offset direction. And here we are able to give what? Distance. Only the thing is that in AutoCAD it is going to keep the base as it is, but here in this case it is going to scale the original one. That is the option called as what? Offset move curve. So whatever options we are seeing, that is move curve, scale curve, pattern curve, offset curve, mirror curve, all this will come under what? Modify. Modify means we require some object to be drawn earlier, and then only we can apply this modify related things, that is quick trim, quick extend, fillet, chamfer, offset curve, mirror curve, pattern curve, offset move curve. Like this it is creating as a offset is there, whether you have to create inside or you have to create the outside is there. So it is going to create offset of the same feature. Suppose if you create circle, I want to create offset for this circle. So offset move curve, we can select the curve to offset this one. Then how much it has to get enlarged, means with respect to circle, how much it has to create offset, and then that much distance it is going to create as the offset. And then we can give inside as well as outside, whatever distance you are going to specify it. So like this we can able to apply what? Offset move curve. Which option is there inside? Below. Offset move curve, scale move curve, and then resize curve. Resize curve, again it is going to specify with respect to the circle. If you specify, if you want to resize the circle, the profile of the circle, if you want to resize it, you select the curve as this one. This is the curve, and then we have to specify directly diameter. Whatever diameter is there, that diameter we are going to specify it. This is the dimension is there. So that dimension I am going to specify. What dimension you want to specify here, whatever thing is there, it is going to get resize the curve. Resize means if you have drawn circle of some pre-described circle, means a radius or diameter value, if we want to make it of some other value with the help of resize, we can do that with the other value. That is the option is called as a resize. And where do you find that option? Inside this one, resize curve. Here we can specify select curve, and here you have to specify this one. Then we have to specify the diameter, whether you want to give the new diameter as below that red diameter, or you want to give the diameter above that the circle is there. So like this we can able to give the diameter is there, whatever diameter you want to specify. Suppose if you want to specify suppose I have done the fillet for this. If you want to click on fillet, that is for a fillet between this. If you want to resize curve now for this one, suppose resize curve, I am going to specify this, that is from center it will be different, whatever different center is there, but as fillet if you specify, fillet point will take it at a center and it is going to vary only what fillet. Can you see it is varying as a resize curve as for only fillet, and if you take here as from center, it is going to vary the entire structure is there. Depending upon that radius, entire structure will get varied is there. Means this radius is becoming increased. That's why it is getting this line and this line, because it is getting resized with respect to what? Center line, means center point. So that's why it is getting resized here and here. Like this we can able to apply it. Like this we can apply what? Resize curve is there. Where do you find this all the option? Inside make corner, move curve, offset move curve, scale curve, resize curve. Same way resize chamfer. Resize chamfer means what? Already you have applied some chamfer. If you want to modify that, like we modify the resize curve of the curve which is already we have drawn. Like I have applied chamfer here. Suppose I am going to apply the chamfer as this option specific dimension. So what I want, I need to modify that chamfer dimension directly without giving dimension. I want to modify that. If I want to modify that directly, I am going to use the option called as resize chamfer curve. So inside this resize chamfer curve, it will ask you to specify what the curves which you want to apply the resize as a chamfer. You can specify as this one. So here if you specify, can you see the chamfer distance? It has been getting increase or decrease depending upon the direction what you specify. That is the dimension is there. Inside as well as outside. So this is the option called as what? Resize chamfer curve is there. Here it is option resize chamfer curve inside and outside. Like this we are able to apply this one. So again you will find this option resize chamfer curve. It will ask select the chamfer curve. You can specify this as a chamfer curve and we are able to apply what? The distance, whatever distance you want to apply for creating that as a chamfer, you can directly edit it. So once again I tell whatever commands we have specified with their shortcut. For profile the command shortcut is Z, for rectangle it is R. You want to note it down, you can note it down the shortcut for different profile, means a different sketcher related option. Profile it is Z, rectangle it is R, line it is L, arc it is A, circle it is O, then studio spline it is S, polygon it is P. Then what we have studied, for ellipse there is no shortcut, for conic there is no shortcut, for offset there is no shortcut, for pattern which we have seen today, the remaining option that is layout, circular and general there is no shortcut. Again when we come here, trim is the shortcut, that is quick trim, it is a T. T is the shortcut for executing what? Trim as the option. Extend it is E, extend the command shortcut is what? E. Fillet it is F. Here it is there. So apart from this option, all the options will not have shortcut. We have to select it from here. Where do you find mirror curve? If you click here, we can specify this as mirror curve. Again, what I told, whatever mirror you want to apply it, we are going to specify first the object to apply mirror. Then we have to specify center line. We have to compulsory click here center line. And then we can use the pre-existing line if you want to specify already you have drawn. We can specify that line as the center line, and by default if this option is on, convert center line to reference, it is going to convert this line into dotted mode. It has converted what? The line what we have selected into the dotted mode is there, and directly it has applied what? The mirror curve. It has applied what? The mirror curve is there. So trim again I will explain. T is a shortcut. We can type T, we can drag it and we can directly select it. If you want to perform extend, we can type E. E is the shortcut for performing extend. We can specify the entity. It is going to extend up to the next point. Whatever next point will be there, it is going to get extend up to that one. That is the extend is there. Quick trim and quick extend is there. If you want to apply fillet, I told F is the shortcut. We can directly first give the value, whatever offset you want to specify, I mean the fillet. Whatever fillet you want to apply the dimension, we can specify. What I said,
I can directly drag it if you want to create, or else what we can do, we can select the two line, then it is going to apply the fillet option. Same thing with the chamfer. Again, for chamfer there is no shortcut, we have to go through here. Chamfer is there. Chamfer means fillet, means it is going to create tangent arc to the two entities what we select. And chamfer means what? It is going to create the angular portion. It is going to select the angular portion. So here we are going to specify these two line, and then we are going to specify as what? The symmetric and the asymmetric as the distance, whatever distance is there. So like this we are able to give what chamfer is there. So like this we have seen some draw tools, some modify tools, some of the dimensional constraint and some of the geometrical constraint. We have seen today lot of it is modify, that is we require to draw some profile and then we are going to apply what the modify related command. In the previous session we have seen most of the commands were related to draw. So I told when we are going to cover the sketcher related part, we are going to go one by one, that is we are going to specify first the draw, that is the line, circle, arc, polygon, ellipse, these are relatively come under draw. Then we have started with modify, offset, pattern, move curve, offset, move curve, scale, trim, extend, fillet, chamfer. These all the options will come under what? The modify. It is going to come under what? Modify tool. And we have seen the some of the what command, some of the geometric constraint command we have seen, and we have seen what the some of the dimensional constraint command is there. So I have told shortcuts. Again I am telling, profile it is Z, just note it down if anybody want to note it down. Profile it is Z, rectangle it is R, line it is L, arc it is A, circle it is O, studio spline it is S, and polygon it is P. Studio spline S, polygon P, circle is O, arc is A, line is L, rectangle is R, and profile is P. And for trim it is T, extend, that is quick trim and quick extend. For quick trim it is shortcut is T, for quick extend the command shortcut is what? E. For fillet the command shortcut is F, and if you want to give any type of dimension the command shortcut is what? D, that is rapid dimension. And if you want to give some geometric related constraint, the command shortcut is what? The C is there. C is the geometrical constraint. If you want to specify some geometrical constraint is there. So like this, I have told each and every draw related commands with along with the shortcut, and I have explained how to execute that command. I have also explained about some of the modify command and how to execute it. So you try to make the practice of this, that is the draw related options and the modify related options. Just see whether you are able to execute it or no. I have told along with shortcut and how to execute it. So just see this sketcher related some of the draw commands and modify command. As I told, the sketcher is the base, so you should practice this all the commands related to the sketcher, that is the draw commands related command as well as the modify related commands is there. So like this we are going to apply this draw related command as well as the modify related commands is there. Some of the dimensional constraint how to apply, and some of the geometrical constraint how we are going to apply it. Just see and make it the practice of this one. Okay, fine. Thank you.